So, I thought it would be funny to just be doing March of the Vegetas. The fact that the announcer is like, Vegeta. You're just like, I think even the announcer's like, oh no, he's doing the March of the Vegetas. So yes, I am. Yes, I am. And this is an unwise decision. But I thought, you know what? Some of these games, they have, like, this weird thing of making clone characters or characters that are somehow related to each other working quite well when they're a team battle. Now, all of the thoughts of me thinking of this, any examples I can think of are now completely gone out of my head. But, like, for example, in LoL, they have, like, characters that are all, like, in a similar art style or a similar species, like, Amumu and friggin', all of those short characters, and they can all run as a five-player team and actually work and be viable? I don't know anything about LoL. Fucking MOBA, I don't care. Allow me to show you a power you could never achieve. A power you will never achieve, blue head man.
Yo, you threw your tail back?
That's a power you'll never achieve, Goku. Your tail's gone. Because Toriyama doesn't want to show tails anymore. Yeah. Weird thing about base Vegeta. His specials either go direct, straight line, horizontal, or straight line, vertical. And it's just a little weird. But it's pretty neat, it gives him his own style. The irony that, like, base Vegeta has, like, a lot more variety than the other counterparts of Vegeta, than, say, Buu and Super Saiyan Buu, is kind of weird, actually. Because there will be a few. It's a weird trajectory, but once you get it, you always forget that this Vegeta doesn't have a big fire attack without having to burn the air. Show me more! That was my own final flash. So that's too close. Something I forgot to put on the Super Baby 2 thing. So I saw a thing where he can call in people he's like defeated as assists, and I don't know how to do it. I only don't played Super Baby 2 once. This battle has only made me stronger. Grumble, grumble. Grumble, grumble, snicked bub. Time for base Goku. Base Goku's pretty good fun when I was playing him. When I was like, oh, this is pretty good. He's got the Kaioken. He's got the Spirit Ball. Oh, this is kind of fun. That was that. And then I was thinking maybe one day I'll go back to playing him, but I like the shading on that. When he holds his hand. I'm not going to go easy on you. Prepare to die. Prepare to die. They gradually drew
cut above the rest.
They gradually drew Goku and Vegeta to look a lot more similar in the face as time went by. But the original Toriyama drawings, they were quite different in the face. Very different in styles and like size. And then it just kind of gradually they all got more of the same eyebrows. Oh, I'm getting put in a pot. Damn it.
Don't order me around! Let's go! Wide open! Let's go! Easy! It's over! Come here!
Garlic gun. I really like garlic gun. It's cool move. What is this being launched on cold? Jeez, man, it's just Piccolo. Calm the fuck down.
Don't expect to get a thanks from me.
They all have the same pose. Like, well, two of them have the same pose with their inspecting their fist thing, and it's kind of funny. Oh, now it's Kid Goku. I'm like trying to make a thing. I'm sitting here going, look, I'm playing an all Vegeta team. Ha ha ha. And then I'm fighting literally every team I fight has at least one Goku in it. And you're like, you didn't want the point made, you know what I mean?
Allow me to show you a power you could never achieve.
How come? Now, I'm probably going to get blown out backwards because I don't really check this stuff.
My body might be smaller now, but I'm still the same Goku.
Ugh, shut up. But why can't base Vegeta turn into an Uzaru? That would be cool. Super baby can. I've never seen this, so if someone says, oh yeah, one of his level 3s is that and it's hidden, I'm going to be like, fuck you. Really? Vegeta is being beaten up by a child. Hit him. Good. Just keep punching the child until it dies. Okay, that then gets taken out of context. I will never play as a child character. I looked at Teen Gohan. Practice mode. See, I learned. I've learned how to do all that move. Didn't learn how to do all this move. Android 21 is also a character that I looked at in practice mode and was like, me! And I never played her again. Thought I was done, and then I just go, wait, final flash! I thought that was pretty neat. It was like bang, 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 and then I let myself fall, and then I finally flashed. Did you know I like garlic gun? Can you tell by the fact that I've literally garlic gunned all over the place? Nothing but garlic. Oh no, Gohan's down. Gohan's punching all of these losers. Everything I do is getting like knocked back by Gohan at the moment. You know what, I didn't really mean to do that. Yeah. Not too bad. It could have been better. A lot of things bad. I don't know why it was facing the wrong way. Stomp.
You think I would be defeated so easily?
Vegeta is downright like
all right,
tiny. Base Vegeta is just tiny against any of the Saiyan. It's kind of weird, actually. I know that we're in a universe where Krillin exists, but I'm still like, what? Like, why do certain characters in this like anime like just need to stop growing at a certain point? Is that when their development shuts off? They're just like, okay, yeah, like he's gonna literally physically stop developing as well as plot developing. But like Vegeta gets loads of stuff in comparison to Krillin. Krillin gets nothing. Like Krillin gets nothing by the end of the Saiyan saga. Except for like Android 18.
You know there's no use in running away.
That doesn't even happen really, does it? It's not really until post the Android saga.
It looks like I have to fight.
He's even dating her and it's really
get ready!
This shit happened to me. Oh, wow. This Android 16 gives zero chance. But you know, I could try not being hit for 30 seconds. There you go. Oh, he's locked it all. Oh. No, my Vegetas. All my Vegetas. Don't let him do anything ever and it'll be fine. Oh, you let him do something, now you're dead. Oh! If you assist Super, over here, Vegeta, helping Vegeta, helping Vegeta. I am losing track between yellow hair and blue hair Vegeta at times because I also put him in the same outfit as Super. And sometimes I'm not paying much attention. Oh. Yeah, I'll just be gang attack. Oh wait, I can't. Oh shit, I fucked up. That's enough. Yeah. Otherwise, a bit silly. I might win. Just gotta beat up the mighty Gotenks. Oh shit. Keeps moving around. Come on, come on, come on. Fuck you. How did I survive? Don't forget the pain. Somehow just with blue Vegeta at half health. It won't be easy. Which Vegeta is your favorite to play as?
Honestly,
it may be base. It may be base Vegeta. Although I seem to be able to more easily do stuff with the blue Vegeta. I think base is more fun. Like, you're doing more fun stuff. Like, it's interesting, it's diverting. And, you know, like, he's got slightly more different stuff.
Allow me to show you a power.
The blue has some stuff, too, that I enjoy. The base, the start of the Super Saiyan Vegeta is okay, but, like,
I've never
just
let a job go unfinished.
Yeah, you know, it's just, like, there. Although, like, I've watched a load of videos on the various Vegeta meta, and a lot of people say, well, that Vegeta's actually pretty good. I just walked back and forth over that, because I was like, I don't want to get hit by the ice floor. Really sparking already. On a scale of 1 to 10. Oh. Okay. Jumping up at him. I was like, holy shit, this character is just fast and it's very hard to keep track of what the fuck's going on screen. He blocked my final flash. Yeah, let's not have fun, Goku. Just going everywhere really quickly. What the fuck's going on? Like, do I actually like Vegeta or do I just like spammy bullshit? Because I probably like spammy bullshit. But I also think Vegeta is an interesting character. As mentioned before, I like the double voice thing. Yeah. Just go to the left. If I just keep hitting him, it'll be fine. I need him. Yeah.
Close to becoming the legendary Super Saiyan.
Vegeta! Win!
Hey! Clean this garbage up, it stinks!
What a bratty asshole. Another blue Goku. How many blue Gokus?
Brace yourself for the coming battle!
Ah, oh, there's Ginyu. I messed around Ginyu in practice mode and was like, oh, this is Ginyu. Oh, I never want to play Ginyu again. Just it's difficult to understand what's going on.
Allow me to show you a power you could never achieve. Whoa, Vegeta! You threw your tail back?
I feel like this is deja vu, don't you? Straight in with Sparky, okay. Weirdest time to set off Sparky, but okay. Because it's already gone for them and they're like that. They didn't jump down and turn it on. At least it's variety of that time. I mean, Cooler's like a better looking purple dude. How about we're looking at his face?
I alone am more than enough.
So I used to think that that was invincible. I'm pretty sure the charging Big Bang attack earlier used to like have a hitbox that used to knock people back. This is a really good super for when people are rushing in. It's a really good defensive super. The moment they hit the fly button and you pull that out, they're just basically like, they have to try and teleport themselves back out of it. Or cancel.
You think I would be defeated so easily?
Vegeta! Win!
Hey! Clean this garbage up, it stinks!
What a nerd. I kind of want to learn Master Roshi. I played Master Roshi a little bit. He's kind of fun. Bit more technical and confusing.
You know there's no use in running away.
Well, pretty cool for an old man, huh? Care to trade blows with an old man like me?
It's all or nothing! Fight!
All better than go!
Too slow! Take this!
Come on!
Weakling! Be gone!
Something better than me.
Destroy you! Be gone!
I always forgot that this journey is actually like this journey is a bit like, oh, well, how to handle this, I don't know. hate to see anything frozen. And he keeps doing the frog.
Well, the frog.
I don't mind it a hit on this bastard.
I'll put you out of your misery.
Watch me jump into this. There we go. Blue screen. So I was trying to aim for him and I just threw it in. I'm not obviously well versed with basically normal, so sometimes I press a button thinking, oh, that'll hit him and knock him up. But I'm actually not flying into the wrong way.
Guess I'll give you a friend.
Right. I'm not going to out. Well, one mistake, I flew into one projectile and he just doubled down on me. Series of other mistakes, but that was like one of them. But you jumped in front, so that was your fault.
You should respect your enemies.
Now
it's time for me to join in the fight.
I'll
put you out of your misery.
Learn from my mistake. Go to the other side of the screen. Don't do any flying or zooming around. I'm getting hit by a super. Come on, man. Let me just hit you. See, look, I kind of pulled it back here. I could do it. Fuck. I cannot do it. Oh, I might be able to do it. Not again. Robbed. Fucking robbed. That felt like... I didn't even see what hit me. Simply say so. Feels like bullshit. Felt like he couldn't get through the garlic gun. Cannot hope to overcome me. God damn it.
You know there's no use in running away. Are you ready?
Yeah, we've seen this already. Really? That's pretty good. Nearly got that, I just kind of got out of the way. I thought I hit him, saw the super armor, and then just jumped like that. Oh, the deflect. Oh, yeah. I bounced off of Master Roshi's storage card again because it would be a good trajectory.
All better now! It's over! All better now! Come on out! Take this! Behind you, fool! One time, so now I'm not! Take this! Come on, my way! That's the art of it! Let's go! Take this! Don't screw out of my way!
I'm more merciful than I appear.
Be gone! Useless!
I've had enough! Can't you do any better?
Oh,
It happened again. That's the second time it happened to that character. Okay, you walk towards me. You deserve this. Oh, I guess I deserve it. Oh, rolling the duck. Oh, slapped by Brody's clock. I left the blue Vegeta. Now we gotta get Master Roshi off the screen as fast as possible because Frieza's regenerating health the whole time. And you can see he's regenerating his whole health bar if he didn't get it that out as quick as possible. He's doing some shit. Still my boy. Oh, maybe no. That seemed like the safest I could do right there.
Your reign has long been over.
Vegeta, win!
Oh.
Don't ever forget that.
He did it. That was actually surprisingly tough. I don't think Free Vegeta's is particularly a good team. Conclusion. Also, it's not the funnest team that you can play. I didn't really think that was the best fun. Although, base Vegeta, I'm going to have that more of a deeper look later. Because I don't play that enough.